The Automatic Exchange of Information Bill 2023. This seeks to give the force of law in Uganda to the Convention on Mutual Administrative Assistance in Tax Matters and the Multilateral Competent Authority Agreement on Automatic Exchange of Financial Account Information. This brings together 120 countries to provide for the standard for the automatic exchange of financial account information in tax matters and for related matters.
The information on somebody, where he lives, the income that he's getting, so that that person does not come here and claim, for instance, interest. And when it gets to the account where it's coming from, he declares this as dividend, which is not charged in that country.
Because there's this automatic exchange of information, you're going to get information and say, Kagwa International has told us that they have received income from Uganda for interest. So we'll confirm that, yes, in our books that is interest. But if they say they have received interest and in Uganda they declare it as something else, then we'll reclassify.
Appearing before the Parliamentary Committee of Finance to justify the bill, Tracy Akello, a supervisor from Uganda Revenue Authority, says Uganda has been struggling to get information tax information from Ugandans working abroad because the country has not domesticated the Agreement on Automatic Exchange of Financial Account Information, which places an obligation to 120 member states of the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development.
If a country has not domesticated their law, the other countries cannot provide you information. They are not obliged. You can only get that information on a request basis, which is what we've been trying to do as Uganda Revenue Authority.
What this does is that all the 120 countries, really, then they will be obliged to give you that information given the timelines.
Uganda Revenue Authority believes they can be in position to collect over 400 billion in every financial year if the law is passed by the government to guarantee information. Currently, Uganda Revenue Authority collects over 120 billion from Ugandans working in multinational organizations.
We are going to have increase in revenue yield, especially with regard to multinational enterprises and expatriate staff. We'll have an increase in the projection. Currently, we are collecting 243. That is on request for the few requests we've made. So, yeah, billions. So we are looking at over 400 billion. Yes, projection. Yeah, it can double.
The bill places staff sanctions on non-compliancy. For example, failure to file a return on the due date for purposes of the automatic exchange of information is liable to a civil penalty of 250 currency points for each day of default, that is 4 million and 1 million respectively. False or misleading statement in a return for purposes of the automatic exchange of information commits an offence and is liable, on conviction, to a fine not exceeding 2,500 currency points or imprisonment for a term not exceeding 10 years or both. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.